God's name through the mud. You've substituted his name with a swear word. Have you ever had God? Did you ever put God first in your life, sir? Has he ever been number one for Christopher Hitchens?
He's been nowhere for me, as he is, in point of fact.
So the first, second, and third commandments you've broken, the Sabbath, you admitted to that. I'm sure you were naughty as a child, correct?
I don't admit it.
Yeah, but you were naughty as a child, correct?
Excuse me. It's not an admission, it's an assertion.
Did your parents ever get upset with you as a child, sir?
I dare say they did.
Because you were naughty, so you broke that commandment. Murder.
How do you know that's what it was for?
I'm just guessing you're like every other kid I've seen.
But that might not be, made them upset.
Mm-hmm. Because you probably...
It's rather pathetic to have children and then expect them not to be naughty, don't you think?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think the expectation is that they should be
good. I don't know. Are you a father?
Yes, sir, I am. Sir, have you ever committed murder?
No.
Have you ever been angry with somebody?
Repeatedly and justifiably.
No.
Well, I should better say that I don't want to sound smug. Justifiably and unjustifiably, fairly and unfairly.
Because the Bible says that
anger is very important.
Yeah.
Anger is an emotion without which the human species couldn't do. We're onto deadly sins now, aren't we? Not commandments.
Well, I would suggest that righteous anger is good, but if you've been unrighteously angry, then you have committed murder in your heart, because God examines our thoughts and our intentions and our desires.
You should have just asked me if I've committed murder in my heart. I've certainly done that.
Okay, so you've broken the commandment of thou shalt not murder. What about lusting, sir? Jesus warned that if you lust in your mind. So you've broken the commandment of adultery, correct, sir?
Well, none of your business.
All righty. So what we basically done is determine how you'd be doing on Judgment Day. It doesn't sound like you'd measure up at all to God's Ten Commandments.
Who gives a...
Well, we're just playing a little game of what if.
Yes, I'm playing it right along with you.
All righty. So what would God do with you, sir?
I'm glad you think it's a game, by the way.
What would you do...
I rather agree with you.
What would God do with you if he found you guilty of breaking his laws? Would he send you to heaven or hell? What if?
Well, not heaven, I hope.
Mm-hmm. So what would a just God do with somebody like you?
An eternity of praise and groveling and thanksgiving would be my idea of hell.
Mm-hmm. So he'd send you to hell?
I've no idea.
All right. If it's true, if he judged you by the standard of the Ten Commandments, you'd be going to hell.
If you believe in the God of the Old Testament, not, because there's no hell mentioned in the Old Testament.
Mm-hmm.
It's only with the punishment of the dead is not specified.
Mm-hmm.
Right. There, as you, just so you know.
Right.
It's only with gentle Jesus, meek and mild, that the idea of eternal torture for minor transgressions is introduced.
Mm-hmm. So, speaking
so I'm
of
not
Jesus,
sure you know quite so, what you're talking about.
So speaking of Jesus, if, sir, remember we're playing what if, what
I
if it's true that God exists in the... He came to this earth, Jesus Christ, the God-man, the Savior of souls, and he took the punishment that you deserve for breaking God's moral laws. He died on a cross for you. He rose from the dead and defeated death. Let's say that it's true, sir. He died knowing that you, Christopher Hitchens, would spend all of your calories and energy on fighting against him, but he died for you anyway. Would that not be the single greatest act of kindness in the history of your life, if not in the world?
No, it would not.
How come?
Because if I'd had the power or had actually been present, I would have done everything possible to prevent a human sacrifice from being enacted, whether the person concerned wanted it or not.
Yeah, but let's just say
it's
happened.
It's barbaric, and no one has the right or the duty to immolate themselves for me. I don't want it. I didn't ask for it, and I'm not bound by it.
Yeah, that's not the question, though. If it happened, would it not be an act of kindness?
No.
It would be
an act of extreme presumption, saying, what I'm doing now binds someone who hasn't yet been born. It takes away my free will, takes away my autonomy, it gives me no choice in the matter. I'm sorry, it's too bad, the sacrifice has already been made, you're committed. What is this but a very, very crude form of tyranny and intimidation?
Well, it seems like you have the right to reject it, you've done a fine job to date, so if it's true, sir, can't you... at least admit, yes, that would have been an act of kindness. I just don't believe that it happened.
No. I've thought about it quite a lot. I have quite a long discussion of this in my book. You're not trying anything on me that's original or all that daring or playful. I make that assumption and examine it in my book. I say, here's what my reaction is to this offer. Please look it up, and please encourage your listeners to do likewise.
But, sir, we're playing a little fantasy game.
I understand perfectly. I'm not as slow on the uptake as you seem to suppose. How many times do I have to tell you? I make the assumption along with you, and I give you my response to it. No, I don't think it would be an act of kindness.
All right. What if...
I think it's a tyrannical act.
It's a tyrannical act that somebody sacrificed his life for you?
But according to you, he didn't.
All right.
Because he was seen alive very shortly after these supposed events.
Yeah. That'd be the resurrection
from the
dead. Which
is it to be? Did he die or what?
Yeah, he did and rose from the dead. It's called Easter. Been celebrated for a couple thousand years.
To no effect.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm sure that it hasn't affected anybody.
He was supposed
anybody.
To come back in the lifetime of his listeners.
Mm-hmm.
That was a direct promise.
It depends on your understanding of eschatology. Sir, let me play another round of What If before we close our time together with Christopher Hitchens. What if the Bible is accurate? Sir, I want to share a quote with you from the Bible, all right, sir? For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who by their unrighteousness suppress the truth. For what can be known about God is plain to them because God has shown it to them. For his invisible attributes, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world in the things that have been made, so that they, / you, are without excuse. Does that sound like you, sir?
No, it sounds like St. Paul.
Right, but does it sound like he's describing you in Romans 1?
No.
You're not suppressing the obvious truth that there's a creator because you, sir,
prefer
to
Saint
live
Paul
your
when,
own
I
autonomous
prefer,
way.
No, St. Paul is nearer the mark when he talks about the evidence of things not seen and when he admits that most of this is supposition and the things he's claiming to know cannot be known by anyone.
Mm-hmm. So, sir, you're familiar with the Prince of Preachers, Charles Spurgeon, correct?
No.
You've never heard of Charles Spurgeon?
I've heard the name. I can't sound familiar.
Ah, the Prince of Preachers. He said, regarding a fellow like you, somebody who fights and wars against God, typically, if you want to know the reason why, just follow him home. Sir, is it possible that the reason you rage so much against God is because you just want to live your own autonomous way, living any way that you want to, any lifestyle that you prefer, without being accountable to your Creator?
I think that's highly probable, yes.
All right. Excellent. Sir, we appreciate your time. The book is called God is Not Great, How Religion Poisons Absolutely 100% Everything. Sir, we're grateful for your time. Thanks for playing our little game.
Anytime.
Goodbye, sir. What if this is Wretched Radio?